Let's go to Steve in Phoenix, Arizona on Immaculate Heart Radio. Hello, Steve.
Hello, how are you?
Great, sir. So, you a Christian, Steve? You're a Protestant?
Yes.
Okay.
Protestant, yes.
Why is that?
Well, I kind of grew up without a particular religion.
Mm-hmm.
And went through a time in my life, and a friend asked me to go to church.
Yep.
I said, okay. And from that point on, it was became baptized in that church and just started going to Bible studies and reading the Bible and
mm-hmm.
you know, going to church regularly and had a good fellowship with people. And
good.
And it was a positive experience. I can't say anything bad about it.
Mm-hmm.
But I moved and kind of left that church, and there was nothing really to replace that because a lot of it was about the people in the church.
Mm-hmm.
But you can bounce around a lot of different, I guess, Protestant churches. And
you sure can.
Everything's different. It's nothing is consistent. You know, even where I'm at out here, there's lots of Mormons, and you know, there's so many. It's really pretty confusing because everybody has their different interpretations. Of
right, right. Are you feeling a draw, Steve, to the Catholic faith by any chance?
Well, yeah, because I've been listening to different, you know, religious radio stations. I came across this Immaculate Heart Radio.
Yep.
And I just came across your program tonight. But it just seems to have they just approach it differently.
How so? What do you mean?
It's not, everybody's not saying that the Bible says this, the Bible says that. Those quoting scripture constantly, mm-hmm. which I find to be kind of annoying after a while, actually. But I like how it's Bible-based. It's also has a, the meaning isn't taken so literally all the time.
Well, I think that that's important that and this is actually something that really drove me to the Catholic Church when I was converting, you know, 13, 14 years ago. That to me, the Catholic Church made sense of the Bible in so many ways that it seemed to have the right understanding of the literal and allegorical understanding of Scripture, what should be literal, what's not, seeing it from a big picture. And you're right that the Bible says this over and over. Obviously, you're right, we do quote Scripture, but I've noticed sometimes when I read the works of Protestants, and actually there's a very famous Protestant named D.A. Carson who rails against this also. There's a practice called proof texting. It's where someone will say, the Bible says baptism is only for adults, not for babies. And then they right. list after that like 20 verses and say, okay, I'm done, when actually many of those verses don't teach that or they only support that view in an indirect way. Instead of trying to look at Scripture as a whole and trying to take all of it, all the parts, even those that seem difficult. So I think the Catholic Church does that well. The other thing that the Catholic Church made sense of for me when it comes to the Bible is understanding, one, where the Bible came from at all. Because all I've got when I'm converting is, okay, here's a bunch of Gospels. There's other Gospels that weren't included in the Bible. Letters that weren't included. Writings of early church fathers that were read in the early church but didn't end up in the Bible. Well, how do I know the Bible's inspired and inerrant and all these books are supposed to belong there? But if
right.
the church gave us the Bible and it's its kind of divine custodian and helps us not to be led into error when we're reading it and provides, you know, that three-legged stool of revelation, God's word in Scripture, God's word in the traditions handed mm-hmm. on from the apostles and the teaching office of the church, it seems more solid than just Scripture and my own interpretation. So that's what resonated with me. Maybe that resonates with you a little bit.
Yeah, and another thing, too, which actually probably led me more to a Protestant faith was
okay.
I didn't know Catholic people growing up, and I was never invited to be part of this.
That's very unfortunate.
I hope Catholics are listening to you right now, Steve. I wasn't invited.
Yeah, and I think, Steve, I don't have a good answer for you on that one because it's very unfortunate that I think many Catholics look at Catholicism, and I almost want to write a blog post about, you know, Catholicism is the continuation of Judaism and
in the sense of
fulfillment and also how Catholics behave and interact and do things like that. It's unfortunate that, for example, among Jews, proselytism was only common about 2,000 years ago in the first century, that to become Jewish, it's typically through intermarriage. Jews tend to not seek out converts. Some people who come to be Jewish are sometimes turned away at first who want to convert. And I unfortunately think Catholics kind of have that mindset that Catholicism is, you know, you get married in or you have children, and we're not the ones who go out and mission. That's what the Protestants do. But no. Matthew 28, it says right there, go and make disciples of all nations. Right. We are called to do this. That is the point of the new evangelization, which we have many resources on that here.
That was six no's. I counted them. No.
Yeah, well, I think if there's something like the Great Commission and we're not fulfilling it, that deserves a lot of no's.
Right. Steve, frankly, I'm a little bit disappointed. I was hoping for a more high conflict call. Kind of disappointed. No, I'm kidding, Steve. I'm glad you're out there. Please keep in touch.
Keep searching and check out our website, Catholic.com. And Catholics who are listening, Steve's call, it really cuts to the cord. Invite your non-Catholic friends to say, hey, we're going to Mass on Sunday. Or you could just say also, we're going to church on Sunday.
Or Catholic Answers Marriage Conference in Southern California, March 3rd through 5th at CatholicAnswersConference.com. Something like that.
That was a great tie-in, Pat. That was seamless.
But I'm subtle.
Yeah, or to a Catholic event. Maybe there's a talk. Maybe there's a Lenten retreat to help. And especially if there's something biblical, like let's say at your parish there's a Catholic Bible study.
Yeah.
Well, that's a great tie-in with you have a Protestant friend. Come and break open the Word with us. But you have to, it's okay to make that invitation. The worst the other person can say is no.